What you doing?
I'm going to model a bicycle today.
Okay. You know you weren't going to use it.
Well, she's right about that. I'm not going to use that box. I'm going to start by bringing in some reference images. Reference images that I took from a local street. I went and took some pictures of a bicycle that has been placed on just about every corner around here locally. And I'm imagining that may be happening in other places as well. That's the box there. Delete. Centered it. And one of the things is, I see they're for rental. They're bicycles for rental. So I didn't think there would be a problem me taking pictures. I hope there's not a problem with that. But I think they look kind of funny. They stand out. I think on purpose, that's probably a marketing tactic. But I'm going to start by adding the background images, and I'm going to open the images. I did set a directory already for this. Bicycle references. Let me get the thumbnails to come in here. I'm going to try to get the best image that I think I can get, and I think it's going to be one of these. I tried to get the flattest. This is using my phone, and I'm going to set it up for the front view for that one. So if I hit 1 and the 5, there it is. So that looks good. I can always reload the other ones if I need to see the other one, but that looks pretty good. The handlebars aren't too off from parallax, so I could probably just trace one of them. And the wheels look fine. I don't think this wheel is a little higher on the... I can bring the opacity down higher on the axis line there, on the grid line, sorry, than this one. So maybe some rotation. I wonder, yeah, I can do that. So rotate so that they get closer to level. They're very close to level right there. I'm just eyeballing, maybe a little bit back. Eyeballing in between the grid lines. They might be barely visible on the video since it's highly compressed. But basically, I'm looking to make sure that they're halfway down that grid increment that is seen there. And I'm going to use this one to start off. So obviously, there's a vendor name. I'm not supporting any vendor or anything like that. I just think that there's funny. I have some other pictures that I took that shows it's just a bunch of them in a rack, you know, lined up. And I'm wondering if we're going... You know, I remember seeing back in the 90s pictures of China with lots of bicycles. I'm wondering if we're headed that direction as well. So, next image, I'm going to add an image. Let me see, how do you do that? Add an image right there. I'm going to add another image. And I'm going to bring in, again. So that'll be the front one. And I took some front ones. I'm going to have to guess through the thumbnail and maybe even reload a couple of them. That one looks pretty straight right there. And I don't want it in the front view. I want this one in the... it'll be the right view. So if I hit 3, it's there. But that looks pretty straight. I'm going to have to do some rotation. I can see that it's bending a little bit, but I'm going to focus mostly on this fork, the basket, and this. There's not a whole lot of stuff that I can get off of this view, but anyway. So we're going to rotate it. When I say we, I mean me, because there's only me here. What am I doing? Close enough, and now I'm just going to eyeball it. Yes, I went and I erased some of the what would be considered a landmark. Looks kind of crooked anyways. The photograph, I mean. I'm gonna use the wheel for to be as vertical as possible. Just guessing, I'm bringing the opacity down a lot. But now I can see it a lot clearer, and I can see where it's there. The wheel is pretty much the vertical. So the handlebars, they're not quite. You see this handlebars is down. That's just because the bicycle itself is leaning on the kickstand and the basket is not. So maybe, which picture was this? It's the 514, but I'm going to see if I can reload it with another one. And that was that one that I picked. Let me see this one. No. And let me check another one then. If not, I mean, I might just eyeball it. I have a lot of other references here that I'm going to use for the little details that are going to be going into that. Let's try that one. Even though it looks crooked, it looks way crooked. I'm going to try that one instead. So, well, what can I do other than just twist it? Twist it a little bit. Yeah, the handlebars are turning, twisting a little bit. Well, I'm going to leave this one. No, I'm going back to the other one. Which one was it? 154. Okay, going back to this one. Except the closer one. And it was... I almost had it. Kind of doesn't matter because it's more of an eyeball. Okay, so I'm going to use this one and this one. So, and then three. Oh, I don't have to look at the view to see this 154. This is the 154. So that's good. I'm going to save that. The opacity is kind of down. That one, this one is the opacity is okay. So I'm going to start with this, and I thought it'd be kind of funny and cool if I could just get the caricature to ride this bicycle. If they have a distinct shape, they don't have the I was going to call it a truss or a strut that goes across the top here, as most bicycles very thick when you see these bicycles here. And sometimes I just wonder, you know, I moved it around pretty easily, but sometimes when they get pretty thick in the base, particularly here, I have to have a pretty sturdy gusset to make sure that, you know, doesn't bend and stuff like that, or doesn't flex to the point where it fails. But anyways, these are commercially available. My thought is maybe even subsidized by the municipality, because, you know, otherwise some people might get in trouble for just leaving their bicycles out there, right? So there's something going on there, I guess, maybe being allowed to place them on the sidewalks for people to use. And I'm going to proceed to time-lapse the modeling of one of these bicycles, because why not? I'm going to have Candace ride one of these bicycles in the future, as well as play the guitar, which I haven't gotten to that yet. Okay, so time-lapse will proceed from here. Thank you. Okay, for this one, I'm going to call it, I'm going to separate it into parts and call this the first part, the first video. It's already pretty long. The bicycle itself is not going to be red. I'm just using this because it has the shininess that would look like a painted bicycle frame. A couple of things is I always get drawn into doing the detailed stuff that I do here. A lot of stuff in here, and sometimes I guess I have to, that's just with experience, I have to be able to determine how much I want to do in terms of detail, or how smooth I want to get it, because if I'm going to do a rendering that's far off, some of that stuff may not even come through. But in this case, I have a lot of vertices right around here, because the covering of the chain, of the bicycle chain there, I just guessed at this, but then I realized I had some other photos, reference photos, and I look at those off to the side, and it's basically a tube, it's just a pipe or a tube that gets, you know, cut and welded in here. So this is a little exaggerated on the bottom, but I'm going to leave it as such. I'm not going to go change it. So I think this is going to be the frame. I'm just going to have to change the color, give it some materials later on, next videos. But I'm going to proceed then with the next video follow-up for this, in which I will dedicate the handlebars and the fork here in the front. And I think that probably will be a next video, and then parse, and then I'll separate that. The rest of the stuff, the seat and other stuff, all the stuff that's not symmetrical, I'll see what I can separate into separate videos. But anyways, thank you for watching this one. Look forward to the next one. I'm asking, please. I mean, look forward to the next one to finish this up. And thanks for watching if you held out this long.